He's going coast to coast.
Clear the runway. He's coming in.
It's a helicopter slam jam.
He's going to pull up from three. Count.
Watch this guy go.
Dribble drive, backs it in, and gets it.
From the Macon Coliseum and the Macon Centerplex, Macon Madness Day 2. It is time for the boys Class 2A Championship. Calhoun out of Region 7 coming in with a record of 25-2. Going up against Greater Atlanta Christian out of Region 6, undefeated with a record of 31-0. I'm John, this is Sean. Calhoun chasing after their first title in basketball history. Boys or girls have not lost in almost 2 months. Greater Atlanta Christian, Sean, an entirely different story. Numbers are staggering at times. A 49-game winning streak coming into this game, and they got a lot of talent across the board.
Well, they've got talent across the board, but the key is don't put pressure on yourself tonight for winning the state championship. More importantly, try to go undefeated, John. They just got to come in here and play well.
Eddie Martin, GAC, playing for that fourth title appearance in the last 5 years. And there's a very famous last name that we're going to be paying attention to when it comes to the Spartans of GAC.
Yeah, Wilkins is a player that we're talking about. This young man committed to go to Virginia, about 6'8", can really play off the ball, shoots the ball deep, rebounds, athletic. He's the guy we're going to watch tonight.
All right, on the Calhouns, all right, let's talk about Wilkins. You know, we've talked about him a little bit here. You got to look at that hair first and foremost, but a big front line that Greater Atlanta Christian has, and he's obviously going to be key to this, averaging a double-double.
Yeah, the stepson of Mr. Dominique Wilkins. This young man comes in here averaging a double-double, 18 points, 10 rebounds a game. He scores inside and out, has a nice stroke, nice touch, but he has great heart and a big motor, so he plays hard. Also, he has a lot of finesse because of the way that he scores the ball.
Heading to Virginia. Now to the flip side, Calhoun and Balance.
Yeah, Burt is the other player we're talking about, the defensive specialist on this Calhoun team, John. 6'3", but with a 7'3" wingspan. Inside-out player. He's going to play football at Kennesaw State next year. Last game out versus Vidalia, who was undefeated, 24 rebounds. Watching him to be a post presence down low.
All right, let's take a look at our starters brought to us by our friends at Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. It is Riley, the Rev, Chandler Curtis, Austin Bird, and yes, that is correct. It is Keith Fightmaster, the man in the middle for the Calhoun Yellow Jackets. On the flip side for the Spartans, Troy Morrison, Cam Boyd, the son of Cal Boyd, the women's coach at GAC, Eric Jamison, Justin Lewis, and Isaiah Wilkins, who we talked about in the open. Balanced scoring for Calhoun across the board. GAC has a lot of stars. Let's go to the keys to the game, and what do you see?
Well, Calhoun wants tempo. They want to go up and down. Ugly Betty. They do not mind an ugly game tonight that's on the floor for loose balls. They're going to make it ugly.
What about the flip side for GAC?
Well, GAC is going to come in. We talked about them staying focused. You're going for an undefeated season. You're nationally ranked. Stay focused. Win the championship. Play to your strengths. Do not come into the season, to the game tonight, John, and play outside of your strengths. Do the things that got you here to the championship.
Keys to success brought to us by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. Eddie Martin right there in the front in the white sweater, head coach at Greater Atlanta Christian, has the pedigree as a Gwinnett County coach. His first job actually was in 1978 as the eighth grade coach at GAC, and if he looks a little different, lost 52 pounds in the offseason, plus the mustache. The mustache was a bit of a security blanket for him, but that's all gone now. He said he should look more like a basketball coach instead of a defensive lineman. There is Vince Lason. Eddie Martin has more years coaching experience than Vince Lason has on his driver's license. Lason, 31, in his second year coaching Calhoun. And if the name Vince Lason is familiar to you in Central Georgia, it's because he led the Gatewood Gators to their only title in the GHSA back in 2001, a 1,000-point scorer as a guard for the Gatewood Gators and head coach Buster Douglas. We're about to get the AA championship underway at the Macon Coliseum. Troy Morrison will work it up for the Spartans. Calhoun will play man. See them fronting down low, trying to get Wilkins free. Does, jumper, long. Rebound, GAC kicks it back out. jumper outside, rim 0 for 2 off the start in the second opportunity. Calhoun bringing it back.
Well, that's good for Calhoun, John, because you're not giving GAC to come out with that quick spark.
Flat jumper that time by Chandler Curtis. Coming back the other way, GAC off the glass, no good. Wilkins fighting for it up high, second chance in.
That's what he does well. He rebounds. He's going to score in all variety of ways of the game tonight. You have to keep him off the offensive glass.
45 seconds in, 2 points on the board. They go to GAC. They'll break the ice here. Tough man defense. GAC will go to zone if they need to, but they're going to be content to play man most of the time. Want to score their points in transition. Jumper from the outside for Calhoun, rimmed out on the three. Wilkins rebound, outlet to Morrison, who will bring it past half court. So they'll set up the offense, a minute 15 in. Wilkins, free throw extended. Rimmed out, no good. Coming back, Calhoun, one and done for GAC. Called incidental contact there on Kalen Riley. Riley looking for a whistle, didn't get it.
See, John, GAC is forcing Calhoun to play on the perimeter with this 2-3 zone, which is a good thing. That's called coaching. They're probably going to play zone on their makes and man on their misses.
Missed by Curtis on the three, tapped up in the air, brought back by GAC. Wilkins in that 6-7 frame, going to be a presence early on. And you've got Justin Lewis, three at 6-6. Wilkins at 6-7, posting up. It's going to create matchup problems for the Yellow Jackets. We'll see just how much of a problem as we go. Justin Lewis for Morrison. Heavy hands by Calhoun, bringing it back in. Wilkins baseline, drive charge.
And that's what we talk about, ugly basketball. Charges, deflections, loose balls, the type of play that Calhoun prefers, John. And right now, GAC playing directly into their hands.
Here's another look at it down low.
Yeah, that's Wilkins just lowering that shoulder. Great position, good defense. Textbook of taking that charge outside the paint.
Fight master turned into the charge master on that one. 2.5 minutes in. Only one bucket on the board. 3-point, no good. Fight master chasing after it. Which direction does it stay? Stays with Calhoun. Quick hands working defensively for GAC. Finally come up with the turnover. Cam Boyd gets hacked, misses the layup. We're going to call a foul.
John, I'm going to go back to our keys. We talked about ugly Betty, but basically talking about ugly basketball. And this is a great play here on Calhoun running down to the block. Even though they did get the foul, that's the type of play that Calhoun prefers. It's okay. You're going to earn it from the free throw line.
Chandler Curtis gets the foul. Making an appearance here in Macon. Curtis will end up playing football for Coach Lamb here at Mercer next year. The other Lamb, Bobby. Played for Hal up in Calhoun. Coming down here to play for Bobby at Mercer. Free throws missed. Rebound on the inside for Calhoun. Jira Wilson with it. Guarded loosely by Boyd. Riley now. Chandler Curtis. Still working the perimeter. On the cut. Kicks it back out. Thought about the jumper. Thought better of it. Bringing it back out around on rotation. Baseline drive against Wilkins. Shot was short. Rebound up and in. No good on the attempt there. GAC coming back with it. Looks like they're going to set up. Boyd called for it. Wanted the three. Wilkins and jams.
Well, that's called penetration off the transition, John. And Wilkins there, useless athletic ability to throw it down hard.
Calhoun almost lost it on the cross-court pass coming out of bounds. Only 4 points on the board, but they're all GACs so far. Wilson, a long three. Looks short, front of the rim. Rebound underneath is good. First 2 points on the board. There's your icebreaker for Austin Bird.
Well, that's what you have to do, John, against this GAC team. Attack them inside, especially with Wilkins picking up their early foul. He doesn't want to pick up two here early in the first quarter.
Jameson thought about the drive, kicked it back out. Boyd missed the three. Rebound, Austin Bird, and back comes Calhoun. Hands in the passing lane. Boyd knocks it out of bounds. Sticks with the Yellow Jackets with 3:49 to go here first quarter. Three buckets, two of them for GAC, one to Calhoun. And Boyd will sit for a little bit. Garrett Covington, number 10 in, 10 white. Out to guard, Jairo Wilson. Fight master, looking inside, Burr got it.
Attack inside, inside. Wilkins is not going to continue too much because it doesn't want to pick up that second foul here early in the first part of the game.
Pass into the paint, looking. Wilkins kicks it back out. Covington, no. Coming back is Calhoun looking for the lead. Active hands once again. Kalen Riley gets fouled and he'll go to the line.
Well, John, nobody's kind of set the tone with the tempo, the way the game's going. So that actually was a good possession defensively for Calhoun.
Foul call on Justin Lewis and we're going to take a break. 3:13 for the first. And Isaiah Wilkins making a statement early on for GAC. GAC and Calhoun tied at 4 on the great GPB.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit,
member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members.
We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association
and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex, 3:13 for the first. Calhoun and Greater Atlanta Christian tied at 4. Let's take a look at the road to the championships brought to us by our friends at Georgia EMC. Georgia EMC lighting the way. 61-point win over Union County, Model by 18, Jefferson by 13, and a very tough Laney squad. Only an 8-point win, one of the few times this year that GAC has won a game by less than 10 points. That was only the fourth time overall that has happened to match up Calhoun today. Now to the flip side, the Yellow Jackets, 9-point win over the Green Wave. Beat Westminster by 22, a very tough Coosa squad, 67-59, a Northwest Georgia battle there. And then the big one, knocking off previously unbeaten Vidalia by 13 to get to this game here.
That was a huge game. That was a statement game for this Calhoun team, John.
Once again, Road to the Championships brought to us by our friends at Georgia's EMC. Georgia EMC lighting the way. And there's the man in charge, Vince Lason, 31 years young. Coaches phys ed and health, teaches that at Calhoun. Was an assistant coach for 6 seasons before he took over 2 years ago. About as loose as you can be coming into this game, both he and the kids. Talked to him before the match. He was ready to go. First free throw up and good for Kalen Riley.
Yeah, the confidence is good now for Calhoun, John. Having a lead in this game with 3:13 to go in the first quarter. This is the tempo that they like to play.
Missed the second free throw. Calhoun with the 1-point lead. Early field goal numbers for you. Calhoun 2 for their first 9. GAC 2 for their first 8. On the drive, another whistle. Troy Morrison going to the bucket, doesn't get the basket. It looks like a foul on Austin Byrd. It'll be Austin Byrd's first. They called on Keith Fightmaster instead. 32 instead of 22. Free throw is good. We're tied once again. Morrison, a starter last year. He's the guy that sets folks up on this offense. Leads the team in steals with 6.5 a game assist-wise. Leads the team in steals, averages just under 9 points and 3 rebounds a game. Fightmaster will take a seat. Chapin Ryerson, 20 black, now in, replacing Fightmaster after he picked up that first foul. GAC with a 1-point lead.
And GAC back to that 2-3 zone, John. Trying to match up, forcing the perimeter play here from Calhoun.
Curtis and Wilson playing catch. Curtis 5, looking for the introduction into the paint. Bird, high right-handed shot, no good. Wilkins the easy rebound. Outlet, Troy Morrison. Big cross-court in a hurry. Covington, easy 2.
Anytime you send 5 guys to the offensive glass, you got to protect. the transition basket. Calhoun didn't get back. Easy two for GAC.
GAC still working at zone. Thought about a jumper. Double team there. Riley had it, lost possession of it, out of bounds. Will stay with Calhoun. Last touch by GAC. Let's take a look at the GAC on the break.
Yeah, transition always a key in any type of game. You got to protect the backcourt because you can't give up easy, uncontested baskets.
Riley driving right hand short. Wilkins rebounds. Morrison bringing it down for GAC. That cross court has been there more than once. Covington thought about it, kicks it back out. Jumper good by Justin Lewis.
And John, I'm sitting here thinking the first team that establishes some type of perimeter play is going to control the tempo of this game, and GAC is doing a great job up by five.
In the playoffs, Lewis has had double-doubles last three times out. One of their blue-collar guys, a Windex guy, will do the cleanup on the rim for Eddie Martin. Right now, GAC up 10-5. They're on a 6-0 run. Three-pointer good, and we'll bring it back the other way. Chandler Curtis with the three. Wilkins, jumper, short. GAC crashes with two. Calhoun comes out with the basketball. Driving, losing it out of control. Coming down the other way. Easy layup. Tyler Hamilton with two. Make it 12-8. Ryerson and Curtis playing catch up high. 2-3 zone, still packing it in for GAC. Bird low corner, entry pass, turn. Ryerson gets the bank.
Yeah, the bank was open there for Calhoun. Great way of attacking the zone right there at the high post.
12-10, under a minute to go, first quarter. Loop pass coming back the other way. Calhoun coast to coast, off the glass, not there. Wilkins rebound. Wasted opportunity for the Yellow Jackets. Back comes GAC with numbers 4-on-2. Dipsy Doo was missed, rebound by Wilkins in.
Yeah, five guys got to retreat in transition. Great follow-up by Wilkins, John. He's playing up and down the court, not hitting his outside shot, being very effective on the offensive glass.
Looking for one shot. It's going to happen in a hurry, and a foul call on Troy Morrison on the reach-in on Kalen Riley.
And, John, that's not good. That's not a good foul there for GAC. Again, attacking the offensive glass. Tried to go underneath for the reverse layup. There's Wilkins there following up for the easy basket.
Wilkins so far in the first quarter, 6 points and seven boards. Season averages 18-10. Well on his way there. 1.2, got to put up something quick. Kalen Riley off the rim, no good. And that'll do it for the first 8 minutes. Back and forth early on. GAC and Calhoun chasing after the boys' double-A title. Isaiah Wilkins making a statement early for the Spartans. How will the Yellow Jackets respond? We'll find out when we come back on the great GPB.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Animal agriculture is important to Georgia. Our farmers work hard each and every day to take care of our animals across this state. Hi, I'm Ziffy Duval, president of Georgia Farm Bureau, and we're proud of our partnership with Georgia High School Association. Just as we teach our children to work hard and accomplish goals, we take care of each other like a family. We as farmers across this state love our animals, and we work hard to take care of them too, don't we, Jen?
Visit us online at gfb.org.
Right now I'm about 100 feet high, traveling at about 50 miles an hour, just thinking about where I should go next. You have any ideas? Visit us on our Georgia Traveler Facebook page. Gotta go!
GHSA State Basketball Championship Weekend, only on GPB.
The wheels of progress haven't been very active lately. But because of business people like you, things are beginning to get rolling. And Regions is here to help, making it easier with the expertise and service to keep those wheels turning. From business loans to cash management, we want to be your partner moving forward. Let's get going together.
Nothing prepares you better for a great career than the 25 colleges of the Technical College System of Georgia. TCSG colleges produce graduates with the knowledge and training today's top employers are looking for. With campuses across Georgia, state-of-the-art facilities, and outstanding instructors with real-world experience, it's the kind of affordable college education that will fast-track you into a rewarding career. We're building a better future for you. Contact the TCSG college in your area today or go to tcsg.edu.
Coliseum, GAC 14 over Calhoun at 10. Guys, you might recognize number 21 out on the court for his performance, but you also might recognize his last name, Wilkinson. He is the stepson of the former great Atlanta Hawk, Dominique Wilkins. Now, that's not the important thing, though. It's the performance of this kid all season. He's had 17 double-doubles this entire season. He's also committed to the University of Virginia. But I talked to Eddie Martin earlier this week, and he said it's the work ethic of this kid that stands out. He says he's constantly in the gym, that they have to close the doors. Otherwise, the kid would be in there all the time. It's obviously making its mark out on the court tonight. Back over to you, John and Sean.
Thank you, Raven. She'll be patrolling the other side of the floor for us all night. We'll keep us up to date on what's going on. Celebrity Watch last night, keeping us up to date on X's and O's as we start the second 8 minutes. First impressions for you.
Well, the question mark, John, is both teams combined 1 of 10 from the three-point line and both 18 rebounds. So someone's got to start making baskets and hitting shots so we can get on the road.
Calhoun started 0 for 6, and they've hit 4 of their last 10. Wilkins, jumper, square, got it.
Nice touch there from the 15-foot range. Nice touch.
GAC's now made 4 of their last 6 from the field. Leads up to 6 at 16-10. Wilson and Curtis up high. GAC still happy with that 2-3. Long launch 3. Got it.
Well, that was a good shot. Great penetration off the high ball screen, John, against the 2-3 zone. He stepped into it. Curtis did a great job of pulling up for the 3.
Curtis now with 6, both 3-pointers. Wilkins will try it again off the rim too hard. Coming back the other way, it's GAC off the rebound. Fightmaster with a hand in the alley, got it. Turnover for Calhoun. Chandler Curtis thought about it. Wilson, Fightmaster, foul.
Yeah. And Fightmaster, John, known for his athletic ability, going to Samford. That's a high jumper, state champion high jumper, so he can really get up, see if he can finish this off with 2 points from the free throw line.
Foul on Tyler Hamilton for GAC. Nice rotation on the free throw, got it in.
He's got that high jumper look, doesn't he? Just sky for like 7'1" if he can.
Dwight Stone's hair. I just dated myself with that reference. Second free throw good. ...16-15, the Fightmaster free throws have got it down to a 1-point game. The lead was 6 a while ago, but a Curtis 3 and the 2 free throws by Fightmaster have taken it to a 1-point game, minute and a half and counting into the second quarter. Wilkins looking for someone to pass it to. It's all packed in. Jumper from the outside, rim, no. Looks like they're going to call over the back on Eric Jameson.
And see, I like what Calhoun is doing, John. They're taking away the inside play there, Wilkins. He can't penetrate from the top, making all the other guys on the team beat them. They've got to knock down some shots. Wilkins can't do it on his own.
Boyd back in, Covington out. For GAC, so the starting 5. Back on the floor for Eddie Martin. Calhoun trying to take the lead after being down 6 no more than just about a minute ago. Chandler Curtis trying to draw Boyd way out in that 2-3. Double team in the corner. Easy right hand shot off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound picked up by Tyler Hamilton. Hamilton drives center of the floor. No traffic there, but once again, hands in the passing lane, create another turnover by GAC, and back comes Calhoun to set up an offense.
Yeah, ugly basketball, exactly what we're seeing here now, John, and that's the style of play that Calhoun likes. Make it look ugly, make it ratty, and hit some shots.
Rim no good, 2 GAC players fighting for it, coming out with it, Justin Lewis over Troy Morrison. Morrison will bring it up. clear out by Tyler Hamilton with the arm. Tries to put up the shot, doesn't go, but they'll call a foul on Calhoun. Foul on Fightmaster, his first. And then he'll send Tyler Hamilton to the line. Hamilton on the year averaging 6 points a game, 3 rebounds, 2 assists, coming off the bench for the Spartans. This is, makes the first, gets the good roll.
And see, if I'm Coach Martin now, John, I might want to extend the pressure defensively, get the made free throw, and get the tempo back in control in our hands. You're playing into the hands of Calhoun defensively in the 2-3 zone, and they're hitting their outside shots. Offensively, you're taking so much time off the clock, you guys aren't playing relaxed.
So Eddie Martin directing a little traffic there with this free throw. Rims in.
So right now, here's a great time to gain that momentum, put some pressure on the ball, extend the defense.
Garrett Covington coming out to meet Jira Wilson with it. Curtis thought about the three, kicks it back out. He's guarded by Tyler Hamilton up high. Takes the jumper, line drive, no good. Rebound Wilkins. Wilkins will clear. Hamilton, cross court high. They wanted to go way up high. Fightmaster with that jumping ability, another hand in the passing lane, knocked it out of bounds.
Yeah, that's just great defense transition. Getting back, protecting the basket. It could have been easy, too, on the lob.
Last touch by GAC. Calhoun will bring it back in. Wilson and Curtis. Kalen Riley. Keith Fightmaster. Austin Berg, your five right now for Calhoun. Troy Morrison, Garrett Covington, Justin Lewis, Wilkins, and Boyd for GAC. Quick pass up high, Riley on the baseline. Back out to Curtis, thought about the drive, kicks it back out, and they'll try it again. 4.5 minutes to go, first half. GAC with a 3-point lead on Calhoun, a back-and-forth ball game. Lead has been 6 points. Got a couple of ties, too. Long 3-point attempt, way short, in the paint. Looks like they're going to call a foul on Cam Boyd on the reach in that time on Austin Berg.
And that's what Calhoun has to understand. They've got to go inside, attack Wilkins. He may block the first shot, he may block the second shot, John, but he's not trying to pick up that second foul.
16th foul for GAC. First free throw is long. Fightmaster will sit again. Ryerson comes back in, 20 block. Second free throw, took a little off it. That one goes in, the margin's back to 2. Right now your perimeter numbers, GAC 0 for 4 from 3 points.
Here's a lob, here's a lob, here's a lob. Wasn't there, the back screen was set.
Looked like an elbow to the chops almost hit Troy Morrison. You saw his head snap back as Jira Wilson caught him on the way by.
Yeah. Well, they set the flat screen on the baseline, John, and looked for the lob to Wilkins, who just got defended well. That's good defense on Calhoun's behalf.
And trying to do that, Eddie Martin trying to create some kind of momentum, some kind of a boost that he can give, because the ugly Betty that you were talking about early on, that's what we got.
Yeah, that's exactly what you have. But here's the thing. If you want to win a championship, you can't create the momentum offensively. You got to do it on the defensive end, and that way that'll create easy scoring basket for you on the offense.
Morrison up high, guarded by Wilson, inside on Ryerson, up and in, count it, the foul.
Great basket, 3-point play, good job. Morrison just lowering that shoulder, getting to the rim for the end one.
Three-point play complete. Margin back up to 5 at 21-16.
Again, Joe, I'm going to talk about a little bit more. This is where you extend the pressure. This is where you gain the momentum. You score a 3-point play. Now you exert a little bit more energy defensively to create turnovers.
Ryerson out high. Jira Wilson. Austin Berg. Chandler Curtis. Guarded by Garrett Covington. Back near side again to Wilson. Ryerson way out, give and go off the elbow, kicks it back out and try to reset, trying to find some kind of an opening, some kind of penetration. Curtis, a long three, got it.
Yeah, when they can hit those outside shots, John, they've hit 3 here in the first half, and attacking those open gaps in the zone.
Curtis's third three, he has nine. He hit four in the quarterfinals against Coosa on their way to that win. He had 20 in that game. He's got nine of Calhoun's 19 now. Calhoun, perimeter defense. Wilkins, easy two.
Yeah, that's a great move. That is a fantastic move. That's an NBA move with the spin on the baseline, the reverse layup, something I'm sure he was taught by the old man from the Hawks. It's a spin on the baseline, held the defense off, used the rim to protect the ball.
Fallon Austin Bird, his second. Something to pay attention to Calhoun. 2:51 to go, first half. Macon Madness continues. GAC up four. We'll have the rest of the first half on GPB when we come back.
You have to seize any advantage you can get to build a career, even while you're still in high school. That's why the Technical College System of Georgia offers dual enrollment. You earn college and high school credit at the same time, saving you money on college tuition. It's about your future. Dual enrollment jumpstarts your college education and prepares you for work in exciting career fields. Talk to your parents, school counselor, or a TCSG college about dual enrollment, or go to tcsg.edu.
Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex, 2:51 for the first half. Watch Georgia outdoors from inside your living room. You'll be able to cozy up with bats and frogs. Cozying up with bats and frogs. Braveheart to do that. That's Sharon Collins for you. You get to hang on the beach with sea turtles, kayak down the Altamaha, get wild with Sharon Collins, videographer Shane Keating, and nature at its best. Watch Georgia outdoors on the great GPP. They go a lot of places and let you know about Georgia firsthand, up close and personal. Great show here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. And there are the Jabberwockies, I guess, for lack of anything else to call them. There's your whiteout there in the student section for GAC.
Whiteout state championship games here in Macon, Georgia. John, looking at the stats here before halftime comes in 2:51, GAC is establishing themselves inside. Right now they're leading the points in the paint, 14-6. So obviously that was something, a conscious mindset for them to attack inside against Calhoun, use your size, athletic, and ability to gain the advantage.
And that man right there, he might have a double-double in the first half by the time we're done. 10 points, 9 boards right now. Free throw up. Front of the rim, no good. Picked up by Kalen Riley for Calhoun. Margin still at 4. Wilson looking for any kind of rotation. Calls the signal. Ryerson out high, drawing Boyd with him.
And his GAC in a man-to-man. First time all game long.
Riley driving. Muscles it up and in.
And so obviously, Coach Martin realized it's going to be hard to defend this Calhoun team when you go man-to-man because it drove to the basket for the easy two.
Pass on the inside by Garrett Covington. He's the victim of a kick, and so they'll reset it on the baseline. Morrison will inbound. Pack the paint, looking for a three. Too much, but look who's there. Knocked away for the two. And Calhoun will come out with it, but hands active once again. Troy Morrison making up for the miss on the offensive end, comes back on the defensive end, and will start the offense.
Yeah, he redeemed himself, getting that ball back in the transition turnover.
Boyd over the top to Wilkins, whistle on the inside, and go to the line again. Looks like this one's on Ryerson. Or is it on Kalen Riley? It's on Riley. It'll be his first. Wilkins will see if he can add to those numbers. And he does.
He's got a nice stroke there from the free throw line, John. Looks good. He's a great looking basketball player. I think he'll have a good career in the ACC.
Jameson in, Covington out for GAC. As we're under 2 minutes to now. Well, first half, GAC up 3, 24-21. Second free throw, no good. Austin Bird, the easy rebound. GAC withdraws into a defensive posture. Calhoun calls the offensive set. Penetration inside. Change of direction up and in on the way up. Gyra Wilson for two.
Look for Coach Martin to change that defense. Go back to that 2-3 zone, because in a man-to-man, they're using the high ball screen and attacking the rim.
Looping to Wilkins, guarded by Ryerson. Kicks it back out. Boyd thought about the jumper, moved his position, squared, fired, got it.
Nice shot fake, nice fake. Good follow through. A needed outside shot for GAC.
Key fight master ready to check back in for Ryerson at the next dead ball, coming up on 70 seconds to go first half. Calhoun down three, 26-23. Ryerson looking to drive. Ball deflected. Wilkins deflects it twice. Coming back out with it in transition, wide open, down low. Missed the hack, got the bucket, Justin Lewis.
Again, John, we're talking about gaining momentum. Momentum is only gained off the defensive end. You got to stop, you got to transition basket.
That's what Eddie Martin wants to do. He wants them to play free, but within a structure, and have fun doing it. They're doing it so far, up by five at the break, coming up on 30 seconds to go first half. Jira Wilson with it. Cam Boyd on him. We'll go out and challenge. Coming up on 20 seconds. Ryerson looking for anyone to pass to. Steps.
We'll look for a last second shot here with 19.7 to go. John, here in the first half. GAC up by five. Then Wilkinson's going to get the ball to the high post and look to isolate to finish out.
Vince Lason brings in Fightmaster, so it's the two tall guys, Ryerson and Fightmaster, going up against Lewis and Wilkins. Shot deflected, 5 seconds to go. Can Calhoun get a bucket behind the back to Fightmaster for the deuce?
Hey, now you're talking about momentum going into the halftime. That's Calhoun playing the Calhoun way.
A fancy way to put two on the board to close the margin to 28-25. And Raven has Eddie Martin.
Coach, stylistically, what do you think you can change so you can play GAC basketball instead of Calhoun basketball?
Well, we're hoping we can make some adjustments at halftime to start doing that. That's what we're hoping to be able to do.
What are those adjustments, Coach?
Well, we've got to play a little bit better defense. We're giving them too good looks at the basket, and we're not doing much on offense right now but standing. We've got to move a little bit more and run some of our sets, and we'll try to get that the second half.
With that man-to-man, those high ball screens seem to be killing you. Do you think we'll see a zone coming out of the second half?
We'll see.
All right, Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
All right, back over to you, Mark.
All right, Ray, thanks very much. We're at halftime of the boys' AA championship game, and what a wild game it has been so far as GAC, the defending champs, are taking on the Yellow Jackets of Calhoun looking for their first state championship, and this one could go down to the wire.
Yeah, and coming up, we've got first half highlights. You're really going to want to see those. Plus, Grace Olson is going to give us a check of social media and what all you fans at home are talking about. Stay tuned right here live on GBB.
Attention high school students and parents. Going to college is expensive, but at College Goal Georgia Events, students can get help filling out the free application for federal student aid to get money for college. You can also enter to win a $1,000 scholarship. Visit collegegoalga.com.
As a strong, stable bank, we're always looking for opportunities to boost the vitality of our communities by supporting local events and finding financial solutions for our customers in all economic times. Regions is proud to be a partner with Georgia Public Broadcasting in building a better Georgia.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit, member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members.
We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association
and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
When I was in school, I wasn't very interested in what was going on in the classroom. I even considered dropping out. Did you know that high school dropouts commit about 75% of crime? And they make a quarter of $1 million less than graduates in the lifetime? If you're struggling, find someone to talk to. That's what I did. And I graduated high school. And that is a decision that I will never regret.
Right now, I'm about 100 feet high, traveling at about 50 miles an hour, just thinking about where I should go next. You have any ideas? Visit us on our Georgia Traveler Facebook page. Gotta go!
GHSA State Basketball Championship Weekend only on GPB.
Welcome back to GPB. We're live from the Macon Coliseum, live from the GHSA Boys and Girls State Basketball Championships. We are at the break of game two today, the AA boys game between GAC and the Yellow Jackets of Calhoun, and we have an outstanding first half. I can't wait for the second half.
Yeah, we've already had one champion who we've crowned today. We had four yesterday. We've got three more going on. We're right in the middle of one of those, and there are a lot of people who are talking about this game online. So let's check in with Grace Olson, not just about this game, but also about another project we're working on called hashtag Six Words from a Southerner. Grace?
That's right. We're doing this promotion called Six Words from a Southerner on Twitter. I've got a special guest from GAC, a cheerleader, Elizabeth, helping me hold this sign right now. We want you to tweet us six words that describe being a Southerner to you. So tweet us, send us Vine videos, find us on Facebook, whatever it is. We want to know in six words what makes you a Southerner. Can you think of six words that you think make you a Southerner?
Apple pie, Waffle House, trucks, denim.
Denim. Okay, she's got it. We put you on the spot there with that one, but I think you got it spot on. Thank you for joining us, Elizabeth. And this is a tight game here. What do you think is going to happen in the second half?
Honestly, they keep trailing behind, so if it keeps going the way it is, hopefully we're going to win the state. So.
Okay, well, good job putting you on the spot with it. Send us your six words from a Southerner. Send us your Vine videos. Find us on Facebook. Whatever it is, we want to hear from you. Back over to you, Claire.
All right, and remember, we're at 11,000 Facebook likes, a little bit over that. We want to get up to 13, 14,000, so like us on Facebook. Time now to check in with the Georgia EMC scoreboard. One game in the books. Kendrick wins the Class AA Girls Championship this year, knocking off Wesleyan 69-58. We're at the half of the boys' AA game. Defending champ GAC leads Calhoun 28-25. Coming up next, it's the girls' 5A game. The defending champs, Southwest DeKalb, takes on the Lady Tigers of Tucker, making their first appearance in the state championship game in a battle of DeKalb County rivals. And in Class 5A, Miller Grove takes on Warner Robins. Miller Grove going for six wins in a row. Should they win, that'll be a boys' record in Georgia.
Now it's time for our career play of the game, brought to you by the Technical College System of Georgia. The healthcare field is broad and full of rewarding careers. Medical and clinical lab tech jobs are growing at a rate of over 2% annually. Jobs in biotechnology labs are growing at about the same rate, and Georgia continues to compete in high-paying science and technology fields. Other areas of healthcare, like pharmacy technology, have provided many stable jobs for several years. Even working as a vet tech can be a rewarding way to make a living. That's why healthcare is back in the spotlight as our play of the game. This message is brought to you by the Technical College System of Georgia. For more information on your next career, visit tcsg.edu.
All right, we're getting ready for the second half of the boys' double-A game. GAC is 31-0. Calhoun is 26-2. Both these teams just excellently played a great first 16 minutes.
Yeah, and their fans know it, and they're letting us know it as well. Coming up, you don't want to go anywhere because John Nelson and Sean Golden will have the second half of this incredibly exciting game. We will be back right here live on GPB.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
You can't think about service in Georgia without thinking about our brave men and women in uniform. I'm here today with the Georgia National Guard, and we're very proud of them and their families and how they represent our state. At Georgia Farm Bureau, we're proud about the service we deliver to you and your family and to Georgia agriculture. We invite you to come to your local Farm Bureau office and join our family.
Take advantage of Farm Bureau's many services, from multi-line insurance to money-saving discounts. Visit us online at gfb.org.
Meet John. John has decided to drop out of school, but what he didn't realize is that now this door will be closed to him. And this one too. Well, you get the idea.
Right now, I'm about 100 feet high, traveling at about 50 miles an hour, just thinking about where I should go next. Do you have any ideas? Visit us on our Georgia Traveler Facebook page. Gotta go!
GHSA State Basketball Championship Weekend, only on GPB.
Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex, getting ready for the second half here. The boys' AA championship right now undefeated. GAC chasing after their 50th consecutive win, leading Calhoun only by three at 28-25. I'm John. This is Sean. You said in your keys that the game for Calhoun was to be an ugly Betty.
Well, ugly Betty is a tough way to describe this game, but we're right on cue, John. Both teams, 3-for-18 from the three-point line, and both teams are not, no one is shooting, John, over 68% from the free throw line. So ugly Betty is definitely in the building.
All right, let's find out how we got to where we are, the 53 points on the board. Chandler Curtis.
Well, Calhoun definitely has established themselves being able to score outside. One player, Curtis, hitting all of the threes here in the first half, so that's good for Calhoun. GAC, on the other hand, one player is dominating inside out, and that's Wilkins. That's what he loves to do. He's averaging a double-double, gets it here in the paint, reverse pivot, scoring, doing what he does best. And we look at the stats. Not shooting the ball well, 3-for-18 from the three, and free throws. Calhoun has a total of 6. And GAC has attempted 10, so the fouls, no one's being aggressive, John. And if you keep up this pace, again, we're going to see ugly Betty show her face.
We'll see if she shows up in the next 16 minutes. Halftime stats brought to us by our friends at Farm Bureau Georgia and the stats courtesy of our friends at West Georgia Technical College. Isaiah Wilkins for GAC, 11 points in the first half to go along with 9 rebounds. Leading scorer for Calhoun, Chandler Curtis, you saw his 3 threes. Reminder once again, he had 4 threes in the quarterfinal win over Coosa on his way to a 20-point performance. And are we going to keep seeing ugly Betty as long as Calhoun stays the way it is?
Well, if the game stays tight, John, I think Calhoun's definitely going to stay with their style of play. But GSC is the main concern. I don't believe they're playing to win. I think they're playing not to lose. And when you play not to lose, you tend not to be as aggressive as you should be.
And the aggressiveness, I mean, you've seen fits in here where the teams have been belligerent defensively against the other folks.
Yeah, and right now we're seeing two teams just trying to, playing not to make mistakes.
We'll see what happens in the second 16 minutes here. GAC has the basketball to start things off third quarter. They'll be moving left to right this time. Go over the starting fives. Starting fives looks like they're both in from the beginning of the ball game. Troy Morrison, Greater Atlanta Christian, guarded by Jira Wilson. Cam Boyd flashed. Also flashing was Justin Lewis. Off the underside of the backboard, no good. Got his own rebound up and in.
Well, John, the second half, we're going to see GAC go inside out, more inside than outside to continue to establish their presence.
Lead back up to 5. Kalen Riley driving, easy finger roll for 2. GAC having to work it back down the floor. Loop inside to Wilkins, looking to get it in off the glass. No, but he's going to the line.
And that was a great foul, John. Again, GAC, Calhoun's making GAC earn every basket. They're going to contest every shot. Ugly basketball is the type of basketball that Calhoun likes to play.
Foul on Jira Wilson. That'll be his second. Wilkins to the free throw line. First one's good.
So John Wilkins is doing a great job on the offensive end. He's scoring baskets, he's rebounding. Defensively, he's got to be more of a presence. He's got to contest shots, he's got to block shots, be a more complete basketball player, dominating both ends of the court.
2 free throws good. Wilkins now with 13 of GAC's 32. A little more than a minute gone here in the third quarter. Boys AA championship. GAC, their fourth title game in the last 5 years. Calhoun chasing after their first ever boys or girls championship. Blocked by Wilkins on the inside, and that's the presence you were looking for. Big guy picking it up, bringing it down the floor. Boyd thinks about the three, squares, rim no good. Kalen Riley rebound, Calhoun, back come the Yellow Jackets. Chandler Curtis, nice pass to Fightmaster for the two.
And see, that's the tempo that Calhoun wants. Defend the basket, transition, score.
On the other end, it looks like they're going to call a foul on Kalen Riley as Eric Jamison went up, and if that's on Riley, that's his second.
Both teams are now, John, starting to establish themselves on the defensive end. You get a blocking Wilkins on one end, and then defensive end transition. Calhoun does a great job of taking away the easy basket and coming back with a quick two.
First free throw is short by Jamison there. On the season, Jamison averaging 6 points, three rebounds, and an assist and a half a game. Second free throw is good. One of two, gets the back in. Leads back up to four, 33-29. Wilson, Kalen Riley. Flash Chandler Curtis, disrupted by Wilkins. Boyd coming out with it for GAC. It's like he's about to be double-teamed in the corner. He is, but he gets rid of it in time. Morrison looking to drive down the middle. Kick near corner, short. Back comes Calhoun, and all alone is Chandler Curtis. This one was easy.
And see, now Calhoun has to understand what they did, John. They disrupted GAC by extending their pressure. Put more pressure on the ball, things will happen for them.
Wilkins near side. Jamison and back out to Morrison to reset. Morrison going on Jira Wilson, inside, high off the glass, no good. Fought for, picked up by Calhoun. Calhoun can tie the game or take the lead with a three. Wilson thought about driving. Runs around a Fightmaster screen, top of the key. Kick to Chandler Curtis. No Chandler Curtis will think about a three. Guarded by Boyd, back to Wilson, who will reset. We saw Coach Lason call the play. Wilson guarded by Troy Morrison. There's Riley. Riley driving on Wilkins. Up no good, and the whistle.
And see, that's good basketball on Calhoun's behalf. Attack him inside. Make him defend you in a more physical way instead of coming from the weak side for the block, John. Now you're making him defend on the ball.
Foul called on Wilkins. That will be his second. And as Eddie Martin calls a timeout, we're going to take a timeout with him. 4:49 to go for the third. GAC leading Calhoun 33-31. The AA championship boys side on the great GPB.
Are you getting ready to go to college? Do you need financial aid to help pay for your education? Visit gacollege411.org today and find the information you need to maximize your financial aid award. Learn about the many state financial aid programs the Georgia Student Finance Commission administers, including HOPE. Apply for federal and state student aid with the FAFSA and explore careers or find a college or technical school that fits your needs. Go to gacollege411.org today and expand your opportunities for tomorrow.
Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex, 4:49 for the third. GAC's lead has been cut to two at 33-31. And by the way, GPB Sports is all over social media. Check us out on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Vine, whichever social media you choose to be a part of the GPB Sports family and the GPB Sports experience. Follow us throughout the weekend to see interviews with fans. Parents, check out the cool fan picks that you post and that we post as well. We're posting them all weekend long. Also, follow GPB Sports now on Facebook, at GPB Sports on Twitter. Hashtag GPB Sports during the offseason so you can keep up with all the news in high school sports around the state of Georgia and the United States as it leads up to the start of football season in the fall and beyond. Like and follow us now. And you can use that hashtag as well, GPB Hoops Finals on Twitter. And we'd like the Twitter machine to blow up. We need your help to do it. Go to the Twitter machine at GPB Sports, GPB Sports on Facebook. Find us, Instagram us, six words from a Southerner, all those kinds of hashtags and all those kinds of fun activities that we're doing this weekend here from the basketball championships and Naked Madness on the great GPB. Kalen Riley at the line. After the drive, Wilkins was called for the foul. His second first free throw is good.
And if I'm Calhoun, John, again, I'm saying pressure. Extend your pressure. Make GAC play outside of their comfort zone. Make them handle the ball a lot more.
Third tie of the game at 33. Kalen Riley now with 7 points. GAC working offense around the set. There's Boyd to Morrison. Switch defensively. Boyd Morrison up high. Jamison inside to Wilkins. Double team, triple teamed in the corner. 6'7 fight master on him, but he got to the baseline and off the glass for two.
Yeah, this great patience inside with the ball, knowing that the trap was there, John. He held his composure and was able to score outside of the trap.
35-33 coming up on the halfway point here of the third quarter. Long shot by Riley. Count it.
Those are the shots, John, that sometimes you don't want, but you got to make those to win a championship, especially against the number one team in the state.
Bodies on the floor. They're going to call a jump ball. Timeout wasn't called in time. Alternate possession goes to Calhoun, and here's your three.
Just a double ball screen up top. Stares him down with a deep, deep three.
Seven in the quarter for Riley as he now has 10. And Catoosa County represent. I think that's what the kids say these days. Represent?
Representing. Representing. It's not represent. It's representing. It's a solid T.
Okay. I'll take your word for it. You saw the turnovers right there. Calhoun, their fifth turnover there in the quarter. 6-5 now. GAC leading the turnover battle, but that's not a battle that they want to be leading in. Tough defense for both sides all the way through. 3.5 and under now here at third quarter. Calhoun off the Kalen Riley three, leading 36-35 inside to 6-7.
Yeah, he was demanding the ball the entire possession, John. He couldn't get it from the wing. Take the ball to the high post. He reverse pivoted inside, got position. Nice dunk.
Six in the quarter. He now has 17. 3 minutes to go here in the quarter. Dribble drive off the glass, short. Barely hit. This is what they enjoy doing. Off the set play.
I wonder if he was challenging Dominique sometimes. I can do better than you. How about that? You think that ever happened?
Well, considering that Dominique thought that 61 by LeBron wasn't all that. You want to talk about another influence? He goes from 17 to 19.
Just becoming a force down low, but that's the energy that we like. He's doing it great on the offensive end, John. With the two blocks, he started off the first, the second half. He's now completing his game, which is allowing GAC to have a possible 2-point lead.
Free throw is short. Foul on Austin Bird for Calhoun. Something to keep an eye on. Bird now with 3 fouls for the Yellow Jackets. 39-36. GAC leading Calhoun, a back and forth game. 4 ties. Under 2.5 to go in the third to decide the boys' AA championship. GAC chasing after their 50th straight win. This season, they've beaten teams out of the Bahamas, Tennessee, South and North Carolina, and Vince Lason is going to call a 30 to talk it over. So what do you talk about in this case, just to get him to kind of refocus?
Well, you want him to refocus right now. You're only down by 3 points. You did have a 1-point lead, John. You gave it away with a turnover and multiple baskets back-to-back by Wilkins. But you have to establish yourself, and you're Calhoun, John, on the defensive end. You've got to extend your pressure and force GAC to play outside of a comfort zone. When you play half court, now you allow them to go inside out, get it down low to the big fella, and he's producing 19 points.
Calhoun has done it from both inside and outside. When they challenged inside the paint, there have been those opportunities where they've gotten buckets and drawn fouls. And then also with Chandler Curtis from the outside and Kalen Riley recently to take the lead, Calhoun has shown the capability to do it both ways.
Yeah, they're doing a great job with that, but still, they have to do a better job, first of all, of protecting the defensive glass. You've got a rebound, GAC 24-16 in the boards.
Second chance points huge also for GAC in the game right now. 2 minutes to go here, third quarter. GAC up 39-36. Off the rim, no. For Austin Bird as he drove. They're going to call Justin Lewis for the foul. That'll be his second.
And that's the drive we talked about, John. Get to the basket. Get to the rim. Don't depend on your outside shooting to actually be a presence in this game. Attack the rim.
First free throw is good. It gives Bird six. Now seven.
I see Calhoun's picking up now. They're extending more outside the three-point line. Trying to put more pressure here on GAC.
Wilson on Morrison. Morrison looking to drive. Double team. Bird had him down low. Picked up Boyd off the rim. Doesn't get the bounce. Tip no good. Fight master the rebound. Tried to outlet. Almost deflected by Wilkins. Shouted instructions on the offensive end and some encouragement as GAC heads back down the floor to play defense. 90 seconds to go in the third. Calhoun only down one. Chandler Curtis on Boyd.
Five seconds. 5 seconds. Exactly right. No one was moving.
Coach Lason explaining to Chandler Curtis what was up there. Turnover battle. Now six each. Boyd thought about driving, kicked it around. GAC working the perimeter.
Look at Wilkins work inside. Nice post up. Trying to be a presence. Won the ball down low.
Foul on the reach in by Jairo Wilson as Wilkins was going by. You can kind of see what GAC is doing. Four on the perimeter. Wilkins inside. They're trying to get Wilkins lost in traffic with all of the defenders in the paint.
Yeah. And there's a reason why many consider Coach Martin, I would say, on the modern day Mount Rushmore of high school basketball here in the state of Georgia, because he does know what he's doing.
Missed both free throws. Rebound Covington up, no good. Wilkins tries to tip, no. No third chance there. Austin Bird the rebound. Calhoun with the opportunity to take the lead under a minute to go in the third.
Yeah, Calhoun has a lot of fight, but now let's get the movement going with your offense so you can't pick up another unforced turnover.
Riley guarded by Morrison. Working the perimeter, give to Bird. Guarded by Justin Lewis. Now back it out. Boyd on Chandler Curtis. Drive, teardrop, no. Fight master the rebound, lost it out of bounds.
Man, did you see how high he jumped there? Wow, that was a great job of him pursuing the offensive rebound, just miscontrolled the ball out of bounds.
Under 30 seconds now, GAC can try to expand their lead. And this basketball game has been a grinder.
And see, this is not what Calhoun wanted. They wanted the last shot, just missed a teardrop.
Justin Lewis, jumper high off the glass. No, Wilkins tried to square Covington with the two off the rebound there. And that's big under 10 seconds. Calhoun's got to try to do something quickly if they're going to try to get a shot off. Going to get it off under three off the glass. No, Kalen Riley.
And we have a foul. And we have a foul.
With no time on the clock, Riley got the rebound, threw it up.
The question is, was it on the rebound or the shot? And it looked like it was more of a tip back, so you might want to give him the shot attempt in there, having two free throws.
All right, let's take a look. Ooh, that's close.
Yeah. That's great offensive awareness there.
Kalen Riley to the line. And Calhoun's going to get the last points of the third quarter. Riley finishes the quarter with 12. They put 3/10 back on the clock just to give it something to do. And that'll do it. The long three attempt, touchdown pass, no good. Kalen Riley had 9 points in the quarter for Calhoun. And they're only down one as GAC chases perfection in the boys' AA championship fourth quarter when we come back on the great GPB.
Nothing prepares you better for a great career than the 25 colleges of the Technical College System of Georgia. TCSG colleges produce graduates with the knowledge and training today's top employers are looking for. With campuses across Georgia, state-of-the-art facilities, and outstanding instructors with real-world experience, it's the kind of affordable college education that will fast-track you into a rewarding career. We're building a better future for you. Contact the TCSG college in your area today or go to tcsg.edu.
Welcome back to Chance of a Lifetime. It's the final stage of the game, and it's also time for Jane to choose a door. Help her out. What door should she pick? All right. So, Jane, which door did you choose?
I think I'm going to go with door number two.
Oh, wait a minute. It looks like it says right here that you never graduated high school, so none of these doors are available to you. That's it for Chance of a Lifetime. We'll see you next time.
During this performance, one student will drop out of high school. Be there for your big finish.
GHSA State Basketball Championship Weekend, only on GPB.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
It's been said that championships aren't won by individuals. They're won with team and teamwork. Hi, I'm Zippy Duval, president of Georgia Farm Bureau, and we're proud of our partnership with Georgia High School Association Athletics. In all of our county farm bureaus across the state, we have a championship team ready to deliver services to you and your family and all of Georgia farmers across this state. We invite you to come to your local county farm bureau and be part of our team. Go team!
Visit us online at gfb.org.
Welcome back. Close game here at Macomb Coliseum. 41 GAC, 40 Calhoun. Guys, we talked to Coach Layson earlier this week, and we talked about the game plan. And one of the very things that pointed out to us was the fact that he wants to keep teams to 55 points and under. That's their magic number. If they can keep them under 55, then they can win the ball game. So it'll be interesting to see what happens and plays out here in the fourth quarter. Back over to you, John and Sean.
Thank you very much, Raven. And they are on pace to hold them to 55. So Calhoun's mission is to drive 55. 14 in the first, 14 in the second. Held GAC to 13 in the third.
Yeah, and we talk again. Talk about Ugly Betty. She's in the building showcasing her style, because this is not a good, clean style of basketball that GAC is accustomed to, John. And they're having to fight for everything.
No rhythm at all.
None. No rhythm at all.
Start of the final 8 minutes here to determine the boys' double-A champion. GAC chasing perfection, nationally ranked. Anywhere from 7 to 12, depending on the poll. Wilkins inside, easy two.
Hey, that's a nice penetration, hitting the ball inside. Power jump hook to the middle.
GAC's lead back to three, 43-40. Tough man defense by GAC coming out here in the fourth quarter. Big pick is Kalen Riley trying to go by, but that's what football players are for. Chandler Curtis again for three.
Oh, that's a huge three. Now you tie the game off that three. I think we got something special going here, John.
Calhoun has to get back defensively. Boyd looking to drive. Kicks it back to Troy Morrison. To Justin Lewis thinking about it. They're going to have to work the perimeter as the defense catches up. Morrison directing Boyd down to swap out Garrett Covington. Wilkins, elbow, got it.
Good players, John, dominate multiple possessions back-to-back. The ball has been in his hand. He scored with his back to the basket with a jump hook. Now a soft jump shot at the 15-foot mark.
Wilkins with 23 now for GAC of their 45. GAC's lead is two. Austin Bird, remember, Bird has three fouls as he's dribbling the basketball right now against Justin Lewis. Looks for the drive off the glass, doesn't get the roll. Fight Master mistimed his jump. Wilkins comes down with it for GAC. He'll work the floor. Long pass to the corner to Covington. Works baseline. Fight Master stops him there. Wilkins thinks about it. Give to Boyd. Kick back out to Morrison, who'll set up. Thought about it from the free throw line. Boyd for three. Rim, no. Long rebound and a foul by Covington on the rebound as everyone's trying to clear out and work back down the floor.
Even though it looked like a good shot on Boyd's behalf, the last four possessions, John, the ball has gone inside. And when the ball has gone inside to Wilkins, I would say 90% of the time, John, he scored. So you got to understand the game plan. Get the ball, work inside out with Wilkins. Even if it's going to take you 30 seconds or more off the clock, you still have to continue to establish his presence down low.
Tyler Hamilton, 20 white for GAC in. Cam Boyd will sit. Boyd 0 for 5 in the game from 3-point. Ball knocked out of bounds. Troy Morrison from behind. As Chandler Curtis was trying to drive in for two. 5:45 to go regulation. Calhoun down only two.
So if Calhoun scores right here, I'm thinking you call a timeout to set up your defense. Still, you're allowing GAC to play in a comfortable mode, but they couldn't get the ball in then underneath out of bounds.
Austin Berg was calling for it out by half court. Kalen Riley didn't see him. Calhoun will think about it. Something else coming up here on GPB, we talk about our local programming and our original programming. Georgia Tech Whiz Kids teamed up to compete for cash and a U.S. patent with the 2014 Inventor Prize over on North Avenue. Tune in to GPB Wednesday, March 26th, 7:30 p.m. to see the six finalists demonstrate and defend their innovations in front of a panel of expert judges to see who is magnificent and who'll be this year's champion. Something you cannot miss, the Inventor Prize, Wednesday, March 26th at 7:30, right here on GPB.
John, what would you invent if you were in that contest?
I'm going to have to think about that one. It's a good one. I like that. A perpetual caffeine machine?
Oh, nice.
Considering how much caffeine you and I take in during a weekend, something akin to a caffeine IV machine. That'll work. 5.5 to go regulation. Calhoun setting up offense. Kalen Riley guarded by Troy Morrison way up high. Looking to go around a fight master screen. Wilkins came in to help to try to pick the ball and come the other way. Looks like a foul on Morrison on the drive by.
But here's the strategy, John. Calhoun, what they're doing, they're taking Wilkins away from the basket with the high ball screen. You can get the ball to one of your better offensive teammates on the wing. And that's a clear path to the basket because you don't have his presence down low to block the shot.
Foul on Morrison is his third. Something to pay attention to for GAC as we go a little further along. Jumper, short, long rebound. Bird couldn't get there. Trying to save it as a Calhoun possession in the throwdown. Didn't quite work for Gyro Wilson. Going back is GAC. Top of the key. Jumper, rim, no. Wilkins, easy tip.
Yeah, it's a one-man show now for GAC, John. He's doing it all. Offensive rebound and defensive rebound. Here now, he's the energy guy. He's missed the basketball for this GAC team.
Wilkins has 25 of GAC's 47. Margin back up to four. 4:40 and counting regulation. Riley looking to drive on Calhoun, and he does. Didn't have a shot, kicked it back out to Chandler Curtis. Curtis guarded by Tyler Hamilton. Curtis launches a three, rim, no. GAC has it. They can take the lead to six if they catch transition in a hurry. Nice dish, jump, Covington, no. Fightmaster rebound, Calhoun. Back come the Yellow Jackets. Corner, Curtis, three, rim, Riley, off the glass, fouled by Wilkins.
And see, that's great on Calhoun's behalf, John, because the tempo was good in their behalf. They extended the defense just a little bit, but more importantly, they forced the transition basketball and was able to get in the offensive rebound position and also a foul on Wilkins, so that's number three for Wilkins.
Riley to the line again, misses the first. Another look on the inside. There's a miss.
The deep three, which is great. You did it, clean it up with the offensive rebound. Wilkins picking up his third.
Second free throw. Got it. And it looks like Coach Lason is going to call a full timeout here. He's going to talk things over, which is what you talked about this weekend, coming off of a made free throw. Set your defense. Get everything squared away. Because we're at 4 minutes to go here in regulation. Here's your look at the foul trouble situation.
Yeah, so they're good with 4 minutes and change to go, John, here in the game. So it's more about defense and rebounding if you're Calhoun.
GAC, on the other hand, you want to protect the basketball. You want to make wise decisions. Continue to go inside to the big fella down low.
And you got three fouls, one on the outside, one player on the inside. Wilkins has had a mean third quarter.
Yeah, just elevate with the jump hook, 15 feet out. Nice soft touch. Love that. And here he is again, just being there for the tip in down low.
And they have to give defenders a smushy face when they're trying to go up against that 6-7. In the quarter breakdown, 6 in the first, 5 in the second, 8 in the third. So far, 6 in the fourth quarter, the total 25. Fourth quarter field goals. Although we'll try not to give away any state secrets there for Calhoun. Calhoun, 1 of 5 from the floor in the fourth. GAC, 3 of 6.
And, John, one of the things I noticed about Wilkins, he's not an explosive player. He's not going to beat you for 12 in one quarter, 15 in one quarter, but he's going to score as a balanced attack. And his balanced attack kind of lulls you to sleep at times, kind of the way he plays, because it's not a guy that actually exerts a lot of energy out here in the court.
Raven Toronto on the other side of the floor. What's up?
Guys, I was right behind the Calhoun bench listening to their game plan. Coach Layson said, we've got to get a stop right here. It's a one-possession ball game. Make sure you box out. You'll see a lot of screens down at the end when they get the ball. They said it's very important to make sure they can score and stop GAC, but that doesn't look good right there. Back over to you, John and Sean.
Thank you, Raven. Wilkins now with 27, and the lead is now 5, 49-44. 2-possession game. Calhoun in no need to launch threes quickly as a first shot opportunity.
Just attack the rim. Attack the rim.
And get it rejected by Wilkins as you come by.
That's good, John. He's from the weak side. But anytime you can attack the rim, you're putting pressure on GAC's defense, and they may make a mistake here soon.
Fourth block on the night for Wilkins. Basket from the baseline. Cuts it back to three at 49-46. Morrison looking to drive. Kick to Tyler Hamilton. Will bring it back out to Justin Lewis, who will reset things. Inside to Wilkins.
So a double team needs to come now. Get the ball out of his hands. He scored the ball, John, every time he's touched it in the fourth quarter.
NBA Jam was going. We'd say he's on fire. He's got 29, 10 in the quarter.
Is it butter, baby? He's on a roll.
Going to be thinking about dinner now. 2:50 in regulation. Kalen Riley, they're going to call play on there. GAC, lead of 5. Give it to the hot hand at the elbow. Inside, that's going to be a charge. Are they going to call it? Charge master again.
Yeah, great defense. Great defense. You can hear from the crowd. They're not liking it, but that was fantastic defense there from Calhoun. Just being in the right position, holding his ground, taking it tough.
Tyler Hamilton picking up his second foul there. 2.5 to go regulation, still 5-point lead, GAC. Calhoun can chase after it too. Take your time, do things methodically, still plenty of time to run. Curtis inside, Bird double team, knocked away. Fightmaster can't come up with it, ball knocked out of bounds.
Is that on 21? We have number 4. We have number 4.
4 on Wilkins.
And see, now that is great if you're Calhoun, because you're attacking. You can attack more now, and he is not going to be aggressive on the defensive end.
So there's your subplot with 2:16 to go. As the free throw is missed by Austin Bird. 29 of GAC's 51 have come from the hand of Isaiah Wilkins. Picks up his 4th foul.
He makes this. You've got to call a timeout to set your defense.
Made.
So now you can't allow GAC to go down, John, and use up so much time. You've got to put pressure on the ball.
And they do so. Looks like a timeout called by GAC. As Jairo Wilson was playing tough defense on Troy Morrison. It's going to be a full for Eddie Martin. You see the high school championships here in basketball. Now everybody says that there are 4 seasons. It's not summer, fall, winter, and spring. It's spring football, National Signing Day, recruiting, and Football Fridays in Georgia. Season 4 around the corner, bigger and better high school football games around the state, right into your living room. Join GPB Sports every Friday night to celebrate the athletes, the schools, the teams, the towns, the fans, Football Fridays in Georgia, and the All Access Pass. 3 hours plus live high school football. Season 4 coming up in August, before you know it, on the great GPB.
And the state of Georgia, John, just moved up in the ranks. They were ranked 4th in the nation in recruiting for football. Mm-hmm. They've moved up to number 3.
Well, let's see. It's always Georgia, Florida, Ohio, Texas, California fighting it out.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And the state of Georgia has produced the 3rd most NFL prospects in any other state outside of Florida and California. So it shows you the state of Georgia football is definitely taking it to another level.
It's fun to do it here on GPP. It's also fun to be here as part of Macon Madness. 2:10 to go regulation. I'm going to go ahead and say it. GAC leading 51-47. Wilkins on the day, 13 of 17 from the floor, 5 for 5 in the quarter, on the elbow. Head fake on Fightmaster, didn't bite, kick it back out.
See, Fightmaster has to front the post and deny him the ball.
Like that.
Attack, attack, attack.
Chandler Curtis missed the reverse. Coming up on 100 seconds, Calhoun's going to have to start over on defense. Morrison guarded by Wilson. Looks like the foul on Chandler Curtis, his second. Speaking of football season, you got all these football players playing for Calhoun.
Hey.
Shoulder tackle.
Hey, it's contact sport. It is a contact sport.
Where football is a collision sport. Under 90 seconds to go, regulation. 5 team fouls for Calhoun, 8 on GAC.
Troy Sooner Morrison. Or later they have to foul.
Wilkins, ripped the back of the rim too much. Kalen Riley coming down, 3-on-2 if he wants it. Drives into the paint, trying to draw the fifth. They're going to call a charge.
Wow, what a bailout call. That was a gutsy move to the basket. Thought it was a smart decision, John, on Calhoun's behalf. Don't know if that was a charge. Oh, he was already falling back. So, yeah, the official bailed him out. Didn't want Wilkins to leave the game with 5 fouls.
Instead, it's Riley's 3rd. And a foul on Bird, which will be his 4th. So, Bird with Calhoun, 22, Black has 4. Wilkins, 21, and White has 4. And we're down to a minute 5 in regulation in a 4-point game. GAC is going to talk about it again with another full-time comment.
And see, Calhoun, John, has to figure out who they want to foul. It's a 1-1 right now, so they've got to figure out who they want to foul, put at the free throw line, so they can possibly get a chance to go down and score. It's about fouling now so you can get possession of the ball offensively.
And there's your numbers for Calhoun. Bird picking up his 4th. Jira Wilson, Kalen Riley, each with 3. There's GAC. Wilkins just picked up his 4th. Morrison has 3. So you have your point guard with 3, your postman with 4 fouls for GAC. There you go, there's your up-to-date numbers. So you're still anticipating Calhoun to drive, and try to pick up that 5th on Wilkins when they have an offensive.
Well, it's about this driving and getting an easy basket or a higher percentage shot, not necessarily taking an open 3. Because you get the high percentage shot, John, you call a timeout. There's still time to press. There's still more basketball in this game to come.
Calhoun from the floor, 1 of their last 8. GAC, 3 of their last 5. Justin Lewis will go to the line for GAC to try to make this a 6-point game. Lewis averaging 7.6 rebounds a game. First free throw is good. Heading to Kentucky on a baseball scholarship as a pitcher. That 6'9 wingspan of his. Let's see if he can throw one right down the middle here for a strike. Put GAC's heat up to 6. Long, Fightmaster, and Bird with the rebound. 2-possession game as we're under a minute. Wilson and Riley, give and go. Loses control of it. Who's got it inside? Fight Master fighting with it. Jump ball stays with Calhoun. Tyler Hamilton involved with Key Fight Master. Alternate possession called.
That was a great offensive call with the weave, John. Somebody's got to attack that rim quicker and more effectively.
Riley inbounds quickly, working it around the perimeter. Back to Riley. Squares for a three. Got it. Timeout.
There we go. Score, timeout. Two-point game, John. Look for the press to come.
Two-point game at 42.2 for regulation. And here's another look at it.
Riley coming off that screen really quick. Great elevation. Nice stroke.
Kalen Riley now with 16. No bigger three than that right there.
But you still, John. Now, here's a setup for you, John. It's a two-point game with 42.2 to go. You don't foul initially in the full court. You want to try to get the trap, utilize the 10-second possibly here defensively, and when the ball crosses over half court, now you have to have someone you need to foul.
We talked about the game that Kalen Riley's had for Calhoun. He only had 3 in the first half. He's had 13 in the second. You see Eddie Martin there. There's Vince Lason. 31 years old, second year as the full-time head coach. You saw him there, he just said attack. I said Vince Lason, you saw him say right there, attack.
Here's what's going to happen again. It's full court pressure, John. You can't foul the first 10 seconds. You want a turnover, get the ball into the half court. But if that ball's on the floor, if there's a loose ball, look for Calhoun to attack it and gain possession of the ball.
Alternate possession would give it to GAC. So they'll try to wrap up one more. Wilkins to inbound. Tough defense. Boyd in the game and a foul by Fightmaster. It'll be his second as Cal Boyd was driving past. As Cam Boyd was driving past and thinking about his father. So Cam Boyd to the line. 8 fouls aside, Calhoun and GAC. Boyd's free throw. Got it. 3-point game of 38.5. Garrett Covington in. Garrett Covington out. Eric Jameson in. Trying to hang with Jairo Wilson to get some state secrets as he went over to see Coach Lason and what they were talking about. Second free throw. Got it.
And see what GAC's doing now. Instead of using the timeouts, they're setting the defense so they can keep everything under control.
Tyler Hamilton back in as Boyd takes a seat. 38.5, 4-point game. Calhoun can get a 2 here. Still a 2-possession game. They're going to launch the 3. Got it!
Quick foul, quick foul.
They got the quick foul. It was Chandler Curtis. That'll be his 3rd. Jairo Wilson with the 3 to cut it to 55-54, and here's the rev on display. Square and fire. Here's another look.
He stepped into it. Nice arc on his shot. Good rotation. Good follow through. This kid's from Calhoun, John Payne, with a lot of heart and a lot of desire.
Troy Morrison to the line. Averages 8.5, has 5, first free throw. Got it.
Look for GAC on the make, John, to call a timeout to set the defense and talk strategy.
There it is. Eddie Martin takes a 30. Decides to go to a full.
I'm looking for a 2-2-1 press, a soft 2-2-1 press, John, to force them to use the clock and to switch on all ball screens. A 3 ties the game, a 2 is still a 1-point game. So I'll give up the drive to the basket with the, in the process of contesting the 3-point shot.
GAC 80% from the free throw line this quarter. Calhoun 2 of 4. So if you're Calhoun, whose hands do you put it in? As they're talking strategy, you see Eddie Martin there on the left, Vince Lason on the right.
Well, Calhoun, you know what you want right now? You want Riley on the wing. Maybe the same action if he can get the three, but you also want to be able to drive to the basket as well, too, because it's still a two-possession game. If you miss the three, they get the rebound. That becomes a five-point game because GSC's hitting free throws. Attack the rim, get an open shot. If the two is there, take it.
The wide out hoping for a positive result. They're looking for the lead to stay. GAC's go back-to-back state champs. There's Kalen Riley, who's had a hot second half to lead the Yellow Jackets with 16. Curtis with 14. They've been hitting from the outside. Riley's been hot. GAC 0 for 11 from 3 in the game. Coming up on 20 seconds. Quick 2 and
Chris
a foul.
Switch.
A launch of 3. Riley out of control. They call a block on Tyler Hamilton. That'll be Hamilton's third. And Kalen Riley go to the line. Opportunity to get points with a stop clock.
That's beautiful. That's perfect on Calhoun's behalf. And now coach can do some substitutions right now. Don't call a timeout on the made free throw. Get a substitution up there so you can set your defense.
First free throw's good. Down to 2. Riley now with 17. Second free throw good as well.
Well, Coach Martin helped out Calhoun. They didn't have the defense set, but they've gone offense and defense now, putting his best free throw shooters in the game.
Covington in, Jamison out. Boyd in, Covington out. Wilkins looking for an inbound. Calhoun trying to look for a foul. Don't get the foul. GAC the easy two.
Jonas hit a three-point game.
They need a three. They've been hot from three. Launched off the back of the backboard. No good. Time's going to expire. GAC back-to-back. Talk about the postseason being survive and advance. GAC survived today.
GAC survived the presence of Ugly Betty. But I did like what the GAC team did, John. They didn't lose their composure, and they hit their free throws.
The winning streak is now at 50, dating back to last season. Eddie Martin. There's Raven in the pile. Eddie Martin getting congratulations. Eddie Martin getting another state championship. He got 3 at Norcross. Let's send it over to Raven Tirado with the star of the night in that hair.
You're a senior. What a way to go out. Where does this rank on the most heart-throbbing wins of your career so far?
It's definitely up there. It was tough. They're a great team, but it was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Did you expect it to be like this out here tonight?
We knew nobody gets to a championship game on a fluke, so we knew we had to come out and battle, and they play hard.
How does it feel to go out with 2 state championships?
It's great. I wouldn't trade it for the world.
Well, good luck, and good luck with your college career.
Thank you.
All right, back over to you guys.
Thank you very much, Raven. He's heading to Charlottesville. Eddie Martin getting congratulations with his team. When we come back, you will see the trophy ceremony for Greater Atlanta Christian. 58-55, GAC survives. They get another championship to take home to Norcross. Trophy presentation, we come back with a great GPB.
The GHSA Basketball Championships are made possible in part by Regions Bank, it's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more, and by viewers like you. Thank you. The GHSA would like to thank the Georgia Farm Bureau.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit,
member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members.
We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
The wheels of progress haven't been very active lately. But because of business people like you, things are beginning to get rolling. And Regions is here to help, making it easier with the expertise and service to keep those wheels turning. From business loans to cash management, we want to be your partner moving forward. Let's get going together.
You have to seize any advantage you can get to build a career even while you're still in high school. That's why the Technical College System of Georgia offers dual enrollment. You earn college and high school credit at the same time, saving you money on college tuition. It's about your future. Dual enrollment jumpstarts your college education and prepares you for work in exciting career fields. Talk to your parents, school counselor, or a TCSG college about dual enrollment, or go to tcsg.edu.
Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex. Boys AA Championship, back-to-back for Greater Atlanta Christian. Hard-fought win over the Yellow Jackets of Calhoun. And it is that time where we send it over to Mark Harmon for the trophy presentation. Mark, take it away.
Thank you, John Nelson. Time now for the presentation of the Boys AA State Championship game. For that, we turn the microphone over to the Executive Director of the GHSA, Dr. Ralph Swearingen.
Thank you very much, Mark, and thanks for all the fans that came to see what may have been one of the best championship basketball games we've seen in many a year. It's now my pleasure on behalf of the Georgia High School Association and Georgia Farm Bureau to present the state championship trophy and game ball to Greater Atlanta Christian.
Let's talk to these two guys. Troy, you're a senior on this team. Talk about you get the game ball, the trophy, and winning back-to-back.
Winning back-to-back means a lot to me and my teammates. I'm happy I got to do it with my brothers, my other five seniors, and the rest of my team.
Isaiah, you carried the load out there, a lot of points. Talk about going out a champion. You guys win four of the last 5 years.
It's a great feeling, you know. We wouldn't trade it for the world. We try to work hard, you know, every day to prepare for this, and we got there, so it feels good.
Justin Lewis, Calhoun played a whale of a game. Talk about that fourth quarter.
The fourth quarter was intense. We've been blowing out teams in the playoffs, so when it came to that fourth quarter, we were ready. We've been tested all season, and we were ready, and we came out on top, baby. Yes, sir.
Undefeated, picture-perfect season. Coach, come on over. Let's get a word with the architect of this program. Talk a little bit about this team. Wire to wire, undefeated, back-to-back, 4 of 5. Talk about this team.
Now it's easy to talk about them right now. Calhoun played a great job. They did a great job tonight on us tonight. But these guys right here, they've been resilient all year long. They knew going in they had a big target on their back, but they just kind of grinned about that and just kept plugging away and plugging away and just found a way to win tonight just to cap off an unbelievable season.
Well, congratulations. Like the 300 Spartans, you guys have risen to the top and conquered all your foes. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that.
All right. Congratulations to the Spartans of Greater Atlanta Christian, this year's AA Boys State Basketball Champs. Now let's send it over.